had to control two kingfishers, one male and one female. Their job was to be topographic viewing cameras, like drones, and they had to work like full-size broadcast cameras. The only way I could control them was with a piece of string used as a whip and flick it at them until they were slightly concussed. The next time I looked, it was only the female one that was attached, and she had transformed into a featherless squid.
I open my curtain and there's my neighbour with a trolley full of toilet paper. So I say to him, "What's with the toilet paper?" No one sees or hears me. I look for a shop, but there are none that are open. I find one last one that's open, but the shelves are empty. The toilet paper turns into a white ribbon, floating, flying, bursting through the roof of the supermarket. There was a folded door that allowed two places and times to coexist. These portals existed in the middle of my back between my shoulder blades. This is so you can't interfere with it. You can access it by rotating the top part of your body in one way and then the other, like a key unlocking an entrance.
The people took me to a park.
A show?
A fairground. And I was having some fun with the locals, dancing.
Laughing.
Drinking.
I think it was a wine festival.
Was it? Do they have sparklers at wine festivals? Suddenly a heavily pregnant lady wearing colourful activewear appeared, and she was struggling to carry her second child in her arms. I picked up the child, and I had to follow this woman through a labyrinth. She was an enchantress. Another Raquel Welch, each step caressing the velvet floor. Her lips stopped an inch from my face and she said, "Can you dye my hair?"
There was a short woman with a small hairy face.
Like a rat.
And her two brothers. One was small like her.
Like a rat.
And the other was tall with red gingery hair.
The tall ginger man gave me a silver tray to carry and it was full of sweets and jellies.
I think if you dream about sweet food, it means that you went to bed a little bit hungry. Either that, or you're searching for love.
Well, Kristeva has this concept of the abject, which is this uncomfortable or ambiguous territory between subject and object. It often involves bodily fluids or innards or slimy things, and jelly reminds you of that.
I thought they were cheese dreams. You know, when you eat too much cheese before you go to bed, you have those kinds of dreams.
My mother had been leaving plates of food outside my door, but I never ate them or even opened the door. I imagine the piles of food got quite big for a time, but the cockroaches and the flies had long since been through them, and they put me in a funny drag costume, and I had to watch this projection of a drag queen from another country, and I had to mirror her movements or they would beat me.
Black paper in lethal cross directions, savage like an assassin, professional. I carry too much, taking equipment without asking. My car is full. I worry Sydney University students will steal it. My words are not linear language, I tell the students. Assemble the tree, appreciate the canopy. Then I hide in the dark labyrinth so I won't be seen. Art performance gone too far. Emotional horror.
But as I was trying to help the elephant, I was captured by the enemy from that neighbor's house. Whilst being a prisoner there, I became a double agent and had to manipulate the two executives that ran the xenophobic system between the houses, befriending their wives so that they thought I was one of them. And it was like a battle between Spain and Switzerland. And
I was it's a suburb about to boom. Campsy is happening.
But I'm not concerned with that. I'm in a timeless, spacious world of shh, soundly, shh, sleeping.
Crystalline cathedrals, glacial peaks, depths of crevasses, blues, greens, titanium whites, reflect, refract, glistening. Near the sea, a coastline, the weather was very windy and cold. Could be Scotland.
Or Punchbowl.
Does it matter?
Well, every little detail in dreams matters, so as a rule, it's important to assemble all the fragments.
Yes, all right, Sigmund. On this one night, there would be a blood moon reflecting into this luminous lagoon, and I planned to swim naked.
Naked? So it's an important dream.
Yes, and just by coincidence, it was the same night as his birthday.
Which birthday?
60th.
Naked? 60th? That's an auspicious date.
I had to go to the island, but had not booked the boat to take me there. I had the brochure for a luxury boat. I could see myself on it, surrounded by interesting people full of life and laughter, lots of drinks, and it would be warm. And when I returned to get the boat, it was already full and had departed. I missed the boat.
I started frantically to look around for another boat. After going to lots of kiosks selling tickets, I found a smiling lady who said she had one last ticket left for her boat. The boat started to move and flew from the dock, landing on a still turquoise sea, more like a bay, with Greek columns on the shore.
So it's not Scotland.
Or Punchbowl.
It could be Earlwood, big Greek community there.
It was a mixture of feelings of pleasure, beauty and fear as well. Fear? That reminds me of a little joke, popular in the psychoanalytic community. What for Freud lies between fear and sex? Fünf. And so these visions are a vast ocean rolling on and on and on, saying, where do we begin and end?
You had the experience. Amongst the mundane or sublime, you may just find something that demands to be heard.